Well, I really think the main advantage of using transient transfection versus stable clones is the flexibility of the process. With transient transfection, you can express several types of proteins very easily. Well, in a stable clone setup, you're a little bit limited by the time it takes to generate a stable clone. In addition, to produce your protein of interest is going to take between 5 and 14 days compared to several weeks to months when doing a stable clone.
In viral vector production, transient transfection is the method most people have experience on. Many products, they are still produced using the transient transfection. However, many people also use stable cell lines. But I think there are also many challenges in the use of stable cell lines because they are anyway somewhat leaky, and they often require plasmid transfection of at least one or two plasmids. And in stable cell lines, often inducing agents are used, and those are also a challenge for downstream, how to get rid of those. They often are, for example, antibiotics. I think transient transfection is especially good for the small-scale, middle-scale production, meaning phase one, phase two clinical trials. However, I think by optimizing the parameters well, it can be pretty cost-effective also in a larger scale. For example, to our knowledge, together with FinVector, we were the world's first to produce lentiviral vectors in iCellis 500 using PI Pro mediated transfection. And we have also been using it for AAV production. I think the biggest problem is the cost. The plasmids transfection reagent, they have to be really good quality in order to be used in GMP, and therefore they are expensive. In addition, plasmids, they are something you don't want to have in your final product, and therefore because they can cause immunogenic responses, and therefore they are a challenge for the downstream. People use endonucleases to get rid of the residual DNA, and that enzyme is also pretty expensive. By optimizing the parameters well, it is possible to reduce the plasmid amount and therefore also the transfection reagent amount used for the transfection, and therefore reduce the cost, however still maintaining the same productivity. And there are multiple choices for endonucleases on market, so you can also optimize the endonuclease treatment, meaning the residual DNA removal really well.
So as Hanna mentioned, I think the quality of the transfection reagent is also critical for this kind of bioprocesses. So something that we've developed at Polyplus-transfection is a portfolio of products that can be used for therapeutic application with different quality grades. So we have the PI Pro product line that is currently used by both FinVector and KCT for the application. I think transient transfection is going to increase over the years and become really the main technique to produce both viral vectors as well as proteins. And to improve this development, it's critical that suppliers and producers really work hand in hand to develop the best bioprocesses, the best reagents for these applications. There are specific needs that need to be addressed, such as the upscale from the small scale to industrial scale is still quite a challenge, and this is something we're working on to improve the bioprocesses. Well, we've been working together for a few years. I think we're very honored to work with the pioneer in the world to produce viral vector into the iCellis system. So we've been providing the Kuopio Center with our PI Pro transfection reagent for the production of AAV and antiviral vectors.
Okay, so we have been contacting Polyplus, scientific support of Polyplus, for getting and we have got really good advices from them how to increase the transfection efficiencies and therefore reducing the costs of viral vector production.